So, full disclosure, today's video was kind of a fail. If we're going to be honest about how things turned out, they really didn't pan out really the way I had envisioned. There was a reason for that. A mistake was made, let's just say. But anyway, let's talk about what we were going for. So, if you look behind me, you can see that I'm using the NH-U12A, which is a great air cooler, and I've been using it for a while, and I have nothing to say bad about it, because, let's be honest, I think Noctua knows how to make good air cooler. Can you think of one that sucked? Because I can't. The problem with that air cooler is the fans look like this. So these are the NH-A12 X25 fans. They're new, high-performance, cool-looking fan, but the problem is they're brown, and I'm not a big brown and beige fan. I think you guys know that. Many of you guys are not as well. So the idea was, let's take the fans out. Let's give them a nice paint job, kind of like we did with that graphics card with this cool little holographic paint that I like to use. It's just nail polish, but anyway, it looks cool when it dries. And that was the idea: take the fans out, paint them up real nice, put them back in, and see if we lost any performance. And that's what we did. Kinda. We'll talk about it. So step one for this little project was to get a baseline. We needed to know how well the cooler, you know, cooled my i7-7700K at 4.7 gigahertz in its stock configuration. So the fans in there, no special settings, just plugged in, let everything take care of itself, and how does it run. And that's what I did. We ran Ida64, I ran it for about 15-20 minutes, and I got a nice baseline. So the baseline at that point was a room temperature of 23.3 degrees Celsius and an average package temperature of 78.7, which gave us a delta of 55.4. So there we go, we had a base point. We knew where the fans and how the cooler was performing in its current configuration, so it was time to take it apart, get it painted up, make it look pretty, and see if it hurt anything. So the first step was to mask everything. I took off the bumpers. I was actually gonna keep those brown just to kind of pay homage to the original colors. Plus, you can't really paint rubber too well. But after that, it was take off all the anti-vibration pads, and then I wanted to mask everything off. So a little cutout in the hub that shows the steel and the bearing. I liked how that looked, so I covered that up because I wanted to let that show through in the final product. And on the back side, I covered up the sticker saying what the fan brand was, the model number. I just wanted to keep everything kind of looking like it was almost meant to be that color. So also I took the cable off and covered that up just to kind of not paint anything I didn't want to get painted. After that, it was time to put down the first base coat. So I used an airbrush to paint, you know, these fans. And the paint I used for the base coat, the white, was just an enamel model paint that you could find in any hobby store or Menards. And I basically used the white to cover up everything on the fan. I covered up all the brown, all the beige, just give it a nice base coat in order to the paint on top of down the line. For this base coat, like I said, just simple enamel white paint out of an airbrush. I think I put on three coats, you know, front and back. Basically, I use two little jars if you're following along at home or you're trying to figure out how much paint you need to paint two fans. For these two fans, to put down two or three base coats, I use two little jars. And then also, I thinned it out with a little bit of lacquer thinner. After I had those two base coats down, I let everything dry. And being patient is a big key to success in all this. It's easy to paint something and kind of, oh, is it dry yet? And then you touch it and then you got a fingerprint. So just let everything sit, find something else to do in the meantime. And then everything's dry, move on to the next step. So the next step for me is I wanted to put a little black around the center hub. So again, I used the same enamel paint, this time black, thinned out a little bit with lacquer thinner. And I painted a little black ring around the hub, basically knowing that I'm going to peel the tape off and show the metal through. And you're just going to kind of get a dark halo around the inside of the hub. So after I had the black down, it was time to move to the next color I was going to use, and that was going to be a fluorescent blue. My PC is normally blue, so I wanted to kind of tie it together. And also I knew that I was going to put flake on in the end, so it was going to cover up most of the color. But I wanted to be the underlying base coat, a dark blue or a fluorescent blue, to kind of just make everything look what I thought would be good. So the idea was to paint the hub blue, and then kind of paint the leading edge of the fan blades out towards the tips, but not cover the entire fan blade. The idea was I want the fan to mostly be white, but I wanted the hub to be blue, and I wanted it to kind of taper off on the leading edge of the fan blades, which I thought would look cool. So after I had the blue down, I had everything kind of looking the way I wanted it to. And in case you're wondering, you know, between each color, if you're getting ready to airbrush, I will say I'm not an airbrush pro. I actually just bought one and kind of figured it out during the week on how to use it. But between each coat, I kind of cleaned out the airbrush with acetone, and it just kind of get all the paint out, spray it, kind of do some back flushing if you need to. But the idea is just to make sure that the airbrush is clean before switching colors, or you're going to have yourself a mess. And then use a toothbrush is what I did. A used toothbrush or an old toothbrush dipped in acetone to kind of keep the tip clear, because you don't want it to start splattering on there. So after I had the blue down, I kind of had everything done. The colors that I wanted were down, and it was time to add the flake. And for the flake, you know, I use this Color Club, I don't know what you'd call it, like a holographic silver nail polish. I've used it in the past on the video where I colored my GPU fan, so I knew how it looked and I liked it. The problem with using like a flake in an airbrush, if your flakes are too big, you're gonna cause clogging issues. You're never gonna be able to paint it. But luckily for me, this paint, this nail polish, the flakes are small enough that it didn't really cause an issue. And then also, when you use nail polish in an air gun or an airbrush, you're gonna need to thin it out. What I've used was lacquer thinner, and I did a 50-50 split, so 50% nail polish, 50% lacquer split thinner, and that kind of was a good mixture to make it thin enough that it was gonna, you know, flow through the airbrush easily without clogging up, and then it was also gonna not be so thin that you have to put like 1,000 coats on. So if you're getting ready to do this and you want to use nail polish, make sure your flake size is small and use a 50-50 mix of lacquer thinner to, you know, nail polish, and you'll have a pretty decent time. Also, my airbrush, I was using the 5mm or 0.5mm tip. So the idea with the flake is I kind of wanted to do the same as the blue. The blue is the base coat that would kind of shine through for anything not covered in flake, but I wanted the hub to be this nice reflective holographic color and then kind of also peter out as it went down the fan blades towards the tip. So again, I painted the hub with this nail polish holographic color, and then on the leading edge of each fan blade, I kind of just drew out towards the tips, leaving the tips kind of white. And I was really happy with how it turned out. After it was all said and done, you know, the hub looked great. I liked how it had a nice sparkle to it, a nice look, and then everything else was a nice clean white. And then mistakes happened. So after this was all said and done, the paint was on, but it was all kind of different textures. Like the holographic paint was kind of reflective. The white was more not as glossy as the rest. So I wanted everything to have a nice glossy appearance. And for that, I needed to clear coat it. And this is where I went wrong. So I chose a clear coat, which I thought at the time was just a regular clear coat like you would choose any other time. But what I didn't know is that it was an acetone-based clear coat. So I hung everything up, sprayed the clear coat on there, was feeling pretty good, and then I noticed things were running. So if you didn't know, when I said earlier, I was using acetone to clean out my airbrush. So when I used a clear coat, a lacquer clear coat, that had an acetone base to it, essentially I was clear coating my fans and at the same time cleaning them off. So all the paint started to run, and it was just a nightmare. Everything didn't really turn out as planned. But you know, what are you gonna do? It was too late then, so I just let everything dry, and the next day I picked it up, looked at it. It wasn't as bad as I thought it was gonna be, but it still wasn't pretty. But in the end, it did end up looking halfway decent. I wish I would have used a better clear coat and it would have looked a lot better. But when you got it out in the sun, you really took a look at the flake, everything looked nice. When you get up close, that you start to notice that things are a little amiss. The big question is how much did all this affect, you know, the thermals, the performance of the NHU-12A. So I ran the test again, the IDA 64, 15, 20 minutes, and this time our average package temperature was 79.9, and we had a room temperature during that test of 24.7, giving us a delta of 55.2. So really, if you look at it, that's pretty much no change. That's within the margin of error. So painting these fans did almost absolutely nothing to hinder the performance. They work just as good as they did then as they do now. And I even listened to them. I mean, I ran it inside the case sealed up, so it wasn't really loud. Anyway, these fans aren't the loudest fans in the world, but I will say I didn't notice a perceivable audible difference between not painted fans and painted fans. I assume that they're probably a little louder, but nothing that I could tell through the case. So in the end, what did we learn? We learned that if you want to paint your fans, go for it. There's really no downside. I did it to my, you know, my GPU fans, still working great, no overheating issues. I did it to these fans, which are some of the best fans on the market, and I didn't notice any difference in performance or acoustics. So as long as you take your time, choose your materials correctly, you're not going to have a bad time. Your fans are going to be painted the way you wanted to, and they're going to look how you want them to look, and they're still going to perform just as well as they did before. So thank you for watching. This is Major Hardware. If this is the first video you've actually ever seen on my channel, I do appreciate you clicking that button. Let me know what you think down below. Should we maybe try this again where we don't mess it up right at the end, or I don't know. What do you think it looked like? Do you think it looked good? Let me know down below. I'm always checking for new ideas. You guys always have some good ideas for us to try on the channel. So thank you for watching. We'll see you in the next one.